you are looking for Koro, they hear me why why. Now I be say you turn that giriba on top of the German television station, Wazubia TV, channel 98 on top of GoTV cable, Start Time channel 195, my TV channel 17, Wazubia Max TV, UHF 57. In case na antenna you dey use, turn and small, and the thing go clear. And those who go talk say we only do DSTV. We dey there, DSTV 259. So we dey reach you for anywhere on top of where you feel watch us, so that you're going to get all the action to the way they come on smoke inside Nigeria political boxing ring. Today, hey, Yoruba go talk say, congratulations, oremo worewa, oremo worewa, oremo worewa, congratulations, oremo worewa. The reason why I sing that song now, say, if you check your calendar, you go see, say, today now, May 1st, 2019. May 1st, 2019. The start of new month, the start of the second month inside the second quarter of 2019. And I won't pray for everybody. I won't pray for everybody. And they pray, say, inside this month of May, your leg no go kick stone. You no go waka enter inside the trap of bad people. Anything where you put your hand on top, it go bring plenty profit. And you, self, go contribute to the development of our great country, Nigeria. May na special month inside our country, Nigeria. And I go take una back to 20 years ago, on the 29th of May, 2019. He go carry and go back to 20 years. That one go be 29th of May, 1999. Now, after Nigerians don't put fire for military people, they say, oh, we need to give these people democracy and run away. They've been run. We conduct elections. And Chief Olusegun Obasanjo of the PDP, he been win the elections. Now, May 29, 1999, now they swear him in as the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. That year, we don't get 20 years of uninterrupted democratic rule. And if you check up, nothing be like democracy, oh, especially democracy when they work. Because the reason why we have to sit down here, they talk, say, this government must do this. Nigerians need to enjoy. Now, because of the freedom of expression, freedom of speech, and say, we'll go, they talk, they hold our elected representatives accountable. But May 29th still they come. Today, now May 1st, and every Nigerian worker, everybody when they work inside this country, now when I get this salute, I go do it a second time. I go do it a third time. Why? Because if you check the history of Nigeria, the kind of work when Nigerian workers do, the kind of work when organized labor do, before independence, after independence, during military rule, and since Nigeria don't return to democratic rule, labor don't try, Nigerian workers don't try. So today, when we May 1st, we suppose they celebrate everybody when they work inside Obodo, Nigeria. Everybody when they do their best to see, say, this country move to the permanent side for the last time. Now I get this particular salute. We get Ogbonge visitor when go join us inside studio. This na person when we say, if you see him, eh, in face they calm, in voice they, what everybody call soothing. That one means say, in not to they shout, but the kind book when in sabi, hey, the kind book when in sabi, hey, from when in small, eh, after them born out for hospital. You know, say when the boy came for hospital, the first boy came go do now, he no cry, oh. When they carry him for hand for hospital, what did they talk now? My Lord. Now that day, they know, say this one, oh, he go be lawyer. Hey, from small, he read book. Read the level where we say, even if mosquito bite him, he go quote law. Today, we go talk plenty things about the 2019 budget when the National Assembly that we passed yesterday. We go also talk about May 1st. The rights of Nigerian workers, the level and their condition, and especially that 30,000 naira minimum wage, Nigerian governors get ready. I see the hot go hot today. It go come up plenty smoke. Make I go break. Once I come back, we go enter inside the discussion based on as it is hot. No go anywhere when they come back. To ask the heart. Before I go to Africa, I've been telling her, say, Ogbonge visitor, go join me inside studio. And I don't need to talk too much. When he start to the talk, I'm going to say, people sabi book. for inside this country. His name na Barrister Bolanle Olugbani. He sabi book well well, and a lawyer and a social affairs commentator. Anything we concern ordinary Nigerian people, in they carry the matter for head, like person when they sell plantain chips inside traffic. Today, we na go hear word. Once again, Barrister, welcome to our city hall.
Thank you for having me.
Barrister, no waste time. We could just go straight into our talk. Make I start with Happy Workers Day celebration.
Yes, Happy Workers Day to all Nigerian workers.
All Nigerian workers. Make we can't go straight into something when they're very, very important. Some people don't look Nigeria. Since Nigeria gained independence for 1960, even before Nigeria gained independence, they talk, say, when we talk about Nigerian workers and organized labor, they say Nigerian workers, so even though they're not too, they shout their name, but the kind of work when they do, they work plenty with the sea results. Some people talk, say, they don't ever forget people like Pamichael Imodu, Baba Hassan Sumanu. This now plenty of people when we say they do good things for inside Obodo Nigeria, yes, and the average Nigerian worker.
Yes.
But it can't be like say somehow. The labor when we get that time, when they labor, Nigeria gain independence, labor, they pursue military. We can't enter civilian rule. So people go look out for the past 20 years. Then go say this democracy when we get. At least Nigeria supposed don't they reach somewhere. Even if nobody say we don't build upstairs, we supposed don't see foundation.
Yes.
But it be like say labor self.
Be
the
like
thing, you know, they not to get fire like as they supposed they like before. I go like ask you, you know, as we celebrate this May 1st when the Workers' Day celebration, and you they look labor for inside Obodo Nigeria, and you they compare labor to the way we labor day before. In your own assessment, what do you go just talk about how labor day inside Obodo Nigeria?
Well, as you start the talk, where will they talk? The people where laid the foundation, Pamichael Imodu, they do big sacrifice because that time, now British they rule us. They themselves, apart from the struggle of Awolowo Ozik and Ahmadu Bello, they contribute immensely to the point where if they talk, say, make workers strike for Nigeria against colonialists go begin shake. Then give support to all the political leaders that time. To take make sure say Nigeria gain independence. After Nigeria can't gain independence, now Pamichael Imodu lay the foundation for waiting at the call NLC, Nigerian Labour Congress, where Hassan Sumanu come be the first national president around 1978. So all that why now, Labour fight for workers' rights. If person go employ person, nobody say you could just treat her like say na casual labourer, being a slave. Where worker get to get rights, that is, you go employ her, tell her how much you go get. Benefit where you go get, whether na housing, whether na transport, you will get normal working hours. No, be say the worker go work 24 hours a day. You know, get rest. You know, get holiday. You know, get leave. All those things. Then Michael Umodu and Hassan Sumanu, that era, they don't fight for that thing. They fight for them. They gain them. But the problem can't start when military boys, when they take over government, the military now them cause the major katakata will be like say labor no one get power again. Before. Labour now they confront military. If they won't do something, we're no good. Labour go say they will go national strike. That national strike be say all workers go sit down for house. Economy no go move. Workers no go anywhere. Government self go get to bow. Come follow them talk. Say waiting they pain them. Make them solve the problem. Make them find solution to the problem. But during military rule, we can't get some guys who rule Nigeria. Those people who rule Nigeria, they be military politicians. They can't begin to adopt divide and rule. That divide and rule means say Labour will stand gidigba for one side, then they will go find another person. We will be like opposition inside Labour. Then go they say that they oppose the national body. That national body could become begin say it be like say it get two voice. That two voice don't go be one voice again. That two voice go be like say the authentic and then the impostor or the fake. So now that fake now in the military they rule they use for against the organized labour to the point where if they call strike. If the strike will they go, if it be like say 1 week, 2 weeks, that fake labor go say they call off the strike. They go say the people where they lead them for the central body say they don't do the right thing. So it can't be like say labor will be labor where we know it no can't be labor again. No, it no be labor again. They come form them to be like say na TUC, Trade Union Congress and Nigerian Labor Congress, meaning say labor where they won before. It don't become two now. And if those two no agree, that means no possibility of national strike and no possibility of
that the whole government is responsible
for something, and it's when we talk, then government must follow. So if NLC talk one thing today, TUC if you talk another thing tomorrow, the center cannot hold. Things be like say it won't fall apart. But later on, after the era of the Pascal Bafiao, even Adams Oshiomhole, who be governor of Edo State before, he tried small because he tried to reach the point where if he talk, nine Nigerians they follow. Mm. If he talk, nine Nigerians go do. But he don't become big man, that I become governor. Like so government. We don't know Adams again. Where right. We don't know Adams again. But before Adams, we get one man where they call Pascal Bafiao. You know, it be like say that one cooperates small small with workers and he cooperates small small with military. He don't die, you. So I don't go talk bad about bad people. So we can't get some leaders like that. We don't favor the workers where they're supposed to they lead. Then they talk to some people, they collect bribe. Me, I don't see them where they collect bribe, but they talk say they collect bribe. You say no see the way they collect bribe. So they say that they compromise with military government. Now that thing can't begin weaken labor. So labor can't be like say trade union congress that for senior workers, Nigerian Labor Congress now for junior workers.
Right.
So senior workers go talk one thing with their leader, they go announce one thing. Trade union congress, maybe for the masses of the guys when they work for factory, the people who know they're too educated for the labor movement, those ones they get their own leader. So if the two leaders of the Oga Union and the Workers Union, if they no talk, if they no agree, strike no fit hold. So if this one talk one thing today and now we we'll talk another thing tomorrow.
So come be like saying a different voice.
Exactly.
This history where you don't give us about how organized labor they inside Obodo Nigeria, they very sure say people don't write them down. And now why would they talk say, see, as Nigerians, if we not know where we they come from, we not know where we they go. I don't know the person when sit down, wake up one day, say, make we come out history for inside our curriculum. I don't know what the person drink or what he smoke. History when go tell you everything about you. When I see us, Oga Bolanle just explain the thing. I didn't picture the people say, ha, oh, we know, we see, when I hear them swearing call now, all these things, now things when we say, we need to write them down, teach them for our schools so that Nigerian children go know, say, he got people who love this country, who do their best for this country, who make plenty sacrifice. Now, we say one person will come and tell you, big motto, big this, big that, big this, take 5,000, vote like this, vote like that, you're going to cause confusion inside this country. We are moving forward. More quiet on that very, very important aspect. Whether we like them or not, whether Labour gets NLC, TUC, and even now, they don't even get ULC, self. Comrade Joe Ajero. Nigerian workers, nasty Nigerian workers.
Yes.
The suffering when these people they face for TUC, NLC, ULC, nine all of them they face together.
Yes.
And it gets to do with the problem of welfare. Money when workers they collect.
Yes.
It be like say somehow for Nigeria. Some people don't call them bad team. When we say they look, say, if I finish this work, it be like say, I don't go see my pension collect. So anything when I feel see now, thief. Inside us, and they work the work, make a tiff up, and it they cause problem.
Yes.
But we know they hear this one for those when they inside government. In fact, for inside this 2019 budget, some people down already they come out and they talk say this our 8th assembly when then they go. It got what they call severance package. When enter into billion, when they give themselves after then go come out for inside that particular place. But people they talk say if they talk of welfare for Nigerian workers, make we know they do lip service, make we they do action. I won't ask you. You think say we go ever reach one level for this country where Nigerian worker go beat in chest, say, I am proud to be a Nigerian worker. This salary when they pay me, it reach me to take care of my family. Any day when we hear that thing, make we wake up from dream, I've been a reality. It go possible.
Ah, it go tell.
Hey.
It go tell.
Hey.
It go tell where.
Chey.
Because the way when Nigeria take day now, and I say, everybody for himself, God for us all. So anybody will go politics, not be because of God, but because of the Holy Prophet, Jesus, or not be Muhammad, now because of his own self, he take go politics. And when he reach there, he go take care of himself, and generations of his family, when they never born, say, make them day okay. How person go go government? The first priority now, say, make it they make a budget, or make it they make a law to take care of your own future. When Nigerian workers never take care of their own future, 30,000 say when they say make them go pay for every state, they so guarantee say some state get the money to pay them. Say people will never pay 18 months, will never pay 12 months, will owe 6 months, now you go pay 30,000 naira. And then if they don't pay 30,000 naira per month to every worker for their state, what the federal government won't do? Share the money where they give the states. They go increase them because they hear one body where they in charge of increasing money where state and local government they collect. Rebellion mobilization and fiscal allocation committee. That committee now supposed to recommend to National Assembly say Nasuso amount councillor go get, local government chairman go get, Nigerian workers go get, a governor go get, everybody. Now then they talk how much money they go get. That body they talk say they never amend constitution. we go talk how much everybody is supposed to earn in this new agreement we then go do. Mm-hmm. So to pay anybody that new money, it'd be like say, no, quick happen. No. Mm. Meanwhile, NLC they talk, say that money they're supposed to pay every worker from the get-go. Mm-hmm. Because they go begin write governor's letter, say from so day to that money will begin pay the workers. But why we know can they learn from people where they more advanced than us? America know they do minimum wage fight every time. Mm. They don't get outside their law. Say once inflation they go up, oh, inflation they go down, oh, that is the value of the currency. Once it begin get problem, where the thing where we they buy before with 2 naira, now 5 naira we can't buy on today. Automatically, anybody where employ worker supposed to increase in money for a salary to suit that thing where the currency no fit afford anymore. Mm. You understand? It is so for America, it is so for Britain. Now you can't say some states where they generate revenue like Lagos, where they generate maybe like almost 40 billion a month, mm-hmm. say make them pay 30,000 naira. Well, if you work for Lagos State, if you go Zamfara, how much they generate every month? Mm. If you go Osun, say how much they generate every month? If you go Sokoto, say how much they generate every month? If federal government no give them the money, where they go take pay the workers? Mm. When federal government they get money, where they do things, where they're not supposed to take money, do. If they don't give more money to the state and local government, there's no how this arrangement can work. Mm. So we are just at the beginning. We don't know the end of this matter yet. Mm. So me, I look and say, the first fight where labor is supposed to fight, and I say, all those where they make law, may then they give themselves heavy, heavy money mm-hmm. every month, mm-hmm. allowance for doing nothing, allowance for doing this, allowance for doing that, and see where they go, severance package, we go enter like billions of naira, they're supposed to confront them first. Mm-hmm. See how now where they make the law, where they give us millions and billions of naira. How now if you make law where our money supposed to even pass 30,000 naira per month self? Hmm. Why they not fight that fight first? Say all this when they allocate, suspend them, take care of us first, or increase our own self before you take give yourself that kind of money where now one chop.
Hmm. You think say maybe NLC, may I just they think oh, maybe then they look say this fight we won't fight now. We go use this strategy, fight them. Because person when we are white,
yes,
he not go just rush into fight with mechanic. If he rush into fight, mechanic.
Person when they say palm oil.
Person when they say palm oil, the person go stay now. You don't think say maybe labor they use
tactics.
Okay, yeah. Make we use this one small. Make we follow them small because for Nigeria here we don't see plenty strike.
You know
if I say these people self strike, they even they give them blood.
Yes.
Asu don't strike. So they even strike past the way where Arsenal strike and they strike. It can't be like saying that only Asu service strike. But we still get people for inside government where we say, once they leave them, well, after 2 weeks, they'll be tired. This same country, doctors go strike. NLC go strike. These people go strike. He even get one point when I remember, say, they be talking that I say police too, they plan to strike.
They strike like once say, before, say.
Yeah, he can't be like, say, that yes. strike. Yeah. No, they won't really they pay them for body.
No, they work. Oh.
If you go give advice to NLC for the kind of strategy when they go use, the kind of move when they go use, so you say, okay, we don't want to use this one since. Be like, say, no, they work. Make we not use this idea. Wait till you go tell them.
Me, I go tell them, say, now, those where they make law for House of Reps and Senate, now they go begin lobby.
Hmm.
When I go, they go enter dialogue with all those politicians.
Hmm.
Say, okay. You know, they take care of themselves. What about we? Now, supposed to take care of us too.
Mm-hmm.
And then, if you rub my back, I rub your back. Mm. And we'll give them proposal. Proposal where we say, if we not do our own, we are on day okay. We say, go do our own.
Mm-hmm.
This thing, they go play small politics, they go use small diplomacy. Begin follow all these people talk, and then try and reach an agreement and make that into law.
Mm.
So, if that thing is made into law, we go take care of the interests of the workers, that is their salary, their benefit, their welfare. Just like these people are taking care of themselves, that is the senators and House of Rep members, then maybe we can move forward. Even if the president can't refuse, say this thing where NSC, TUC, USC, mm-hmm. where they go agree with the people where the National Assembly, he no go agree or he no go sign up,
mm-hmm.
then go just wait 30 days. Once agreement done day with labor and the people where the National Assembly, senators and House of Rep, after 30 days, House of Rep and Senate can override the president
mm-hmm.
by that veto where president won't use. You then go override that by 2/3 majority votes. Mm. It will become law. So two can play at that game. But NLC, TUC, USC must now begin to adopt political strategy
mm.
to tackle politicians.
Mm. Adopt political strategy to tackle
politicians.
That NLC, TUC, Mona, write this one down. Adopt political strategy to tackle politicians. Make we still talk about the strategy when they use. But remember, say we still get another very important talk. Oh, the 2019 budget, when we say they don't pass. Some people look that budget finish, they say, if this budget go benefit Nigerians, say, it go be miracle. Because when they check recurrent expenditure, where we know they see gain, and they compare that to capital expenditure, when we go see gain, they tell say we still get long place to go. But before we talk about that one, and make we play on one special package, as they consign the match when we say organized labor be match for inside Obodo, Nigeria. They match to say, okay, oh, as we they celebrate Workers Day, oh, see the things when they are mind, oh, make una get out for my government, oh, make una work, oh, make Nigerians' life better, oh, make everybody be less sweet, oh, and make organized labor cooperate with una to see say Nigeria move go the permanent site. After we play this package for now, we will come back. And by the time we will come back, we will talk about the 2019 budget. This budget get plenty action. Ah, trillion. Trillion, not be small money. For Igbo man said, before you call trillion, you must cough. Because you must not disrespect her. Trillion. Now be the money. But we will play on this package from organized labor. Make una see the kind things when they talk about. Una don't see that special package by the organized labor, Nigeria Labor Congress. As they take march, they say, if government want make people life better, it go good when government create what they call enabling environment. They say Nigerians to get sense. All we need now the right environment, and people go they do things where we say the world go look say, ah, God really bless these people. Make we keep everything we got to do with May 1st and organize labor. We know they keep up forever. We just want to keep up so that we'll talk about budget. Then throw the phone lines open. Make una call and talk in our mind. 2019 budget. I don't know whether I will tell you congratulations. Some people tell me, no, don't congratulate me. Congratulate those in government because now only them they enjoy them. Yesterday, inside Obodo, Nigeria, our National Assembly, them budget when President Muhammadu Buhari been carried, go give them for front on the 19th of December, where we hear, and we also hear, on that particular day, people were supposed to work for us. And finally, after 4 months, they don't look at where we're using the power of appropriation. The one where they go wear recommended glass. Look the team where to see whether the team balance. And they don't come decide, say, now 8.916, as an Igbo man, trillion naira. Now in that budget go be. They even add close to 90 billion to the budget. They say the one where President Muhammadu Buhari carry come. They say they don't check out. They say they really need to add to RAM so that the thing go balance well, well. And what if President Muhammadu Buhari been carry go now? 8.83 trillion. But them can add close to 90 billion to make up 8.916 trillion. Now, for budget, you get what they call recurrent and capital. Make a break and down. Recurrent now, the money where they spend, where profits not fit follow and come. Now, J, Alafia, as we they spend and they look, say, okay, oh, God go bless us. Alabama money. But capital expenditure, now the one we go put, say, okay, make we build road, make we put street lights, make we do, say, security, good, make we build school, make we build hospital, make we make Nigeria better with this one, say, people feel see, and then go enjoy, say, the work of government, they go see really well. Make I break under, make we understand. And now, if you check our recurrent expenditure, the one when I explain, now 4.65 trillion naira. If you can't check capital expenditure, the one we go spend, where we go see? That one at 2.94 trillion naira. Before I even talk about the severance package, one money when they say those when they ate assembly, as he be said, they don't they go, we need to give them money when they go use buy bread and biscuits. So that when they go back house, these 4 years when they don't they work for us, they go be say, okay, oh, ah, take, oh. We don't work for now. Take this biscuit, make una share. All these sweets, make una share. Make we talk about the budget now. Recurrent and capital. Under President Muhammadu Buhari, for the first 2 years, you get what we notice. Capital expenditure, they higher than recurrent expenditure. And if you check the history of Nigeria budget, are people surprised? Eh? So if you get capital, they say that one are in line with the belief of President Muhammadu Buhari, say, we must do things when Nigerians go see. But people don't look and say, from the initial, more we do this, so people see, it be like, say, recurrent, don't they pass on? And people, they talk, say, not be just to even put plenty money. Make we check how the budget, they take, they do. If we want mark result for this budget, more we check with the percentage when budget they do. And some people say, when they look the percentage finish, the only percentage when they score high, now to pay people salary and give them money. But the one we get to do with development for the people, in not really the day high. I want to ask you, this 2019 budget, Nigerians get hope? Abi, na same no ni.
Na same no ni o.
Yeah.
Na same no ni.
Ah.
Truth wey person go talk. If it dey bitter, make it dey bitter, but na the truth.
Yeah.
Na same no ni. You know why go, why you know why be same no ni?
Why?
Na say that recurrent expenditure in the first place takes care, as you said, of things that are not going to yield revenue or yield any value or benefit to the economy.
Yeah,
it's for buying petrol into the presidential jet,
yeah,
buying petrol for all the convoys of cars, where president, minister, and all those where they go about, they say that they serve us, where they take carry themselves, they take and buy motor, they take and pay salary, they take and do foreign travel or study leave, going to another country, doing this, doing that. Even the money where they take chop for Aso Rock, and the money where they take buy medicine and injection for Aso Rock, now there the money they come from.
Mm.
So if that money can't be high like that, so and you can't say capital project now 2.something billion. Capital project, now money where they take build roads, hospitals, bridges, secondary school, university, maintenance of infrastructure and development of infrastructure. We go generate employment, put money in circulation, make the economy grow, and add value to the lives of the people by creating, you know, extra income for them through unemployment. Because through employment, because if one person is employed from capital projects, that one person is at least taking care of about 600 Nigerians, either as wives, children, or family members. So once the recurrent expenditure that doesn't add any value to the life of Nigerians and to the economy is the one that is higher, the capital project is just a... it's just a paper tiger.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a formality. There's nothing there. Nothing will change. Nothing will improve.
Hmm.
But the question is this. Why are we operating in the way that we are operating? Even the ones where they say capital project before, high pass a recurrent expenditure, before when this administration starts, when the budget they be like that, you go find out, say, before they approve budget, it go reach like June, July, when the year don't nearly finish.
Hmm.
Therefore, the budget where they approve, to implement them, to execute them, to 100% completion rate, it is very low. At the end of the day, by December, that money where they allocate for capital expenditure, only about 20% of it, or 30%, or at the most 40%, was even released.
Mm.
So that budget, from the beginning, was a failure. There was no impact in the life of Nigerians and even Nigerian workers.
Mm.
So what has really changed? Right now, this current one is to take care of those who are coming in and those who are going from the political class. It does not help to change the lives of the average Nigerian by increasing capital projects, roads, bridges, hospitals, secondary schools, primary schools, clinics, all those things that can add value to our lives, create employment, and generate income, and even move the economy forward. It's not, there's nothing like that that can be attained by this meager amount, considering the population of Nigeria. Then again, if we say you get capital project where you won't carry out, where are the locations of these capital projects?
We need
they,
to know.
Yes, are they spread all over Nigeria, northeast, northwest, north central, middle belt, southeast, southwest, south south? Where are these projects located? And how will these projects that are going to be carried out in the capital projects of the capital expenditure, how are they going to impact on the lives of Nigerians? Nobody's telling us that. What we see is figures on papers, and then the National Assembly has used its power to add about 90 billion to it. Now 90 billion naira is not for the sake of Nigerians. It's not for the sake of Jesus Christ or Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's for those who are in power, because that is the compromise that needs to be made for their project to be approved by the President and the National Assembly.
Hey.
You give me, I take. I take, you give me. Now so they do.
But it get anywhere when we say Nigerians for this budget process.
Yes.
From when the executive go send the estimate, go give the National Assembly. He get anywhere when Nigerians feel they involved. Say, okay, oh, yeah, oh, President Muhammadu Buhari, before you send this thing, go. Now we want chop this soup. Now we know whether or not Momo we want inside, whether or not Shoko, whether or not Shombo, whether or not this, whether or not that. Then if he can't go to the National Assembly, we know, say, using the power of appropriation, the Constitution give them the right to cut, put. Make them they put the things when Nigerians really need it.
Yes.
Not be say somebody go talk, say, you won't go do express for where people will need school. Or you won't go build a field for where people will need hospital. It get anywhere when Nigerians feel they involved. I mean, a God hand with it.
It's supposed to get how Nigerians feel they involved.
Thank you.
If the federal government, the state government, the local government, all of them, as in they get budget, they are supposed to do, what you call constituency or grassroots consultation. That is, they will get like town hall meeting for local, for state, and federal level. Say, Nigerians, we won't enter new year. Minister for Works, I come meet you now. I go get designated area where I'll come meet you now for the 6 geopolitical zones.
Mm-hmm.
What do you need in this geopolitical zone?
Mm.
What should be in this budget?
Mm.
What is your pressing priority? Where, if we do them, go make life easier and better for you and to add value to your life. The person will be commissioner for works for every state, supposed to do them. Commissioner for health, supposed to do them for the state. The supervisor for works, supervisor for health and education at the local government level, supposed to do them.
Mm-hmm.
The president supposed to tell all the ministers to go around the country, to go and ask Nigerians what they really need, what they really want that can make their lives better and add value to the administration and give the impression that the administrations, both from federal, state, and local government are performing by getting direct input from the people and implementing it in the budget as a proposal before sending it to the National Assembly.
Mm.
National Assembly itself, all the Federal House of Rep members, all the senators, they get constituency office. They are also supposed to do backward linkage to their constituency. The district where they represent, senatorial district where they represent, they are supposed to go to them and say, we are here representing you for the next 4 years. In this my kidney, in this my district, or this my senatorial zone, I want to know directly from you, the ward chairman, the local government chairman, the councillors, the party leaders, party chairman in this area, whether irrespective of which party you belong to, everybody in this area come to a meeting, that is 3 months, 6 months before drawing up the budget proposal. Ask them, what is the pain here? Is it water that is your main problem? Is it a major road? Is it do you need bridges? How many schools do you need? All this input is supposed to have been done at the different levels and then passed on to those who are writing the proposal in the various ministries, departments, agencies, that end up being the budget proposal sent to the House of Reps and the National Assembly for eventual deliberation, appropriation, and assent into law.
Hey,
so if that process was not done,
hey,
we're just wasting our time.
Oh, this is where you don't talk, eh? It just shows, eh, for government to work, make Nigerians see, it ain't easy. But you must follow the right steps. May I not talk too much because today, my eye don't open, I don't see things. We go try our telephone lines open. Make una call and talk una mind as you take concern this subject. I never sure that people go they look say, since Monday, hey, umbalara. The kind talk who they talk for here, now talk when concern Nigerians. Now so we they do on top of us in the hot. And when they talk, say, not be only to bring una the news. People will go to say, hey, yeah, then the next week we'll go to another one. No. As Nigerians, we must continue to put our mouth. When people they talk, listen to them. Ask questions if you don't understand. Then think, the reason why God give us follow come brain. Why be say all of us go, they go computer village, go collect brain. Why God give us follow come brain and so that we go, they sit down, they think. This thing when they talk, if we do it like this, this country go better. How we go, they live for country where we say, our grandfather, they shout up NEPA. Our papa shout up NEPA. Our elder ones shout up NEPA. We shout up NEPA. Our children, know they even they see light again. Now generator. Picking when they born for Nigeria today, the first one you go do now,
from birth.
From birth, don't they draw generator. I remember when I small, for this same Lagos, if I come back from school, I don't go forget, Betke International, Jumoni Grammar School, we go for public tap.
Drink water.
Now, every compound for Lagos, every street get borehole. We don't dig. Ezekiel, they call us from Badagry. Ezekiel, good evening and welcome to City Hall.
Yeah, good evening, my guy.
We dey hear you, Ezekiel. Talk.
Correct topic.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, this is your topic, now correct topic.
Thank you. Where are they talk? We dey hear you.
Yeah. The country we dey, you know, good for us at all. You know, fit help anybody. The young ones, they never survive. But if we dey think of who we young, what about the old age? How they go take survive for this country? Because if we are today now, sometimes, even when we never get, how do we want to take help our own parents? You understand? So the government make them try for us well, because all this one, now from one tenor to another tenor, they still remain the same. Nothing they change. They keep promising. When they come for campaign, they promise what they're not going to do. And we will still be full. We'll still follow them. But now, they're not even saying we follow them now. That they use their veto power to do things on their own. You know, get see. But when politics come, they will kill people. People will die. Just because of say we want good government and we need to get the good government. So I don't tire for this country. Even as I did like this stuff, I didn't even think of how they come up for this country. You understand? Make I carry my family. Make I know say I run for here. You understand? So may God help us.
Okay, Ezekiel, thank you very much for this important contribution. And the reason why we discuss Nigeria matter and we talk about solution, now so that we don't go wrong, we go there this country and go better. Make we enter inside Lokoja, the Kogi State capital. Collect this call from Umar. Umar, welcome to Asidi Hot.
Thank you very much. Good evening.
We greet your guy, Umar.
Good evening. Thank you very much. I want to contribute my own for the matter, and my own basically not just NLC. How did they take do their things across board? Nigeria Labour Congress and all those labour bodies they will get, they're not very innovative in terms of doing their things. The way that they do their things, they are cake since 1900. They don't know how to lobby their way to get things done. The previous minimum wage, a whole lot of governors don't see that minimum wage pay. Now, only for presidency, where they do the thing for national year. Now, them see and pay. A whole lot of governors don't see the thing pay. And yet, we still push, say, make them do a minimum wage increase, minimum wage increase, minimum wage increase. A whole lot of these people don't go still pay. They're not going to pay. Even the place where they come from now, the previous one, they don't pay. They still pay percentage. Now, minimum wage, where they increase to 30,000, now they go pay. And this minimum wage, get the way where they can influence things for market. Things will begin to be expensive because even the people for market feel say money don't increase. They feel say workers' money don't increase. They will begin to increase things for market. Meanwhile, for other places, people don't get that money collect. And some of us, we know they even work. We see they go to the same market with people where they collect minimum wage and all that. So it will even increase inflation. But government know they look all that one. Then make a contract matter for the issue of budget. The reason why the current expenditure they go up every day by day on this budget matter now because government know they check corruption. They know they check corruption for budget because if they check corruption for budget, you go see some ministries, parastatals, agencies, computer where they don't buy. For inside last year budget, they still don't budget them for this year, they won't buy them. Motor where they don't buy last year for inside last year budget, this year again, they don't still put them for inside, they won't still buy motor. Now, every day when they buy motor, even the people where they run the agencies and ministries, how many times did they change their motor in a year? They go buy motor. They go use them for 10 years before they change them. But for ministry, all the time that they buy motor, they buy motor. And we call their government with their posture saying they fight corruption. Where the corruption where they fight be? We make our budget skyrocket. This year we are getting about 4.something trillion naira recorded expenditure, and we have 2.something trillion as capital expenditure. It is shameful now. A very shameful thing it is. And yet we still they donate. Millions of naira they give other countries make they do election. It felt very shameful. This country don't tire person just like the way Ezekiel talk so. Time don't reach may everybody begin find a way come up on
this. Oga Umaru, thank you very much for this important contribution. I go see talk as I tell talk for Oga Ezekiel. We not go come out. If all of us come up for this country, who won't call repair them? More we'll come back to Lagos. Matthew, the on top of our telephone line. Oga Matthew, welcome to our city hall.
Hello, this is Martin, not Matthew.
Okay, Martin.
Not Matthew, from Lagos Offshore.
Okay, Lagos Offshore, Oga Martin. They talk, will they hear you?
What I want to contribute in this matter is that everybody in this country have a part to play for this country to move forward.
True.
When we are self-centered, we are thinking of what I can get on my own. The government have their own part to play to make sure that things are going well. The citizens also have their own part to play to make sure that things are going well. Not everybody saying that I want to leave this country, I want to do this, I want to do this. That will never help us in this country. What will help us is let us see what we can suffer so that people will go, the next generation will benefit. As much as we think of what my pocket can be, how my own go better, it will never help us in this country. Let us see what I can suffer. Then let others enjoy. That is, if we have that mindset, this country will be better for everybody. Thank you. This is just what I want to
Okay, Martins, thank you very much for this, your important contribution. I like, say, You talk your mind though, and you not join Oga Umar and Ezekiel when talk say now to run away now come up for this country. No matter how the thing take pepper you reach, tell yourself say you get responsibility. Nobody they run for the face of challenge, especially for country where we say God don't bless. Country where we say na land of milk and honey, where blessings suppose they flow. Oh, the way where Nigeria day, eh? If we do all the thing when God don't bless us with, we use them well. Obama, if you ask him, he go tell you say a name don't be Obama Chukwu. He go add Chukwu to a name because he won't join Obodo Nigeria. We go still take like one or two calls, but make I just allow our Ogbonge visitor chook mouth to talk what people don't talk. Barista, if you hear what these people talk, it be like say don't they reach the level where we say people don't they tire.
Yes.
They don't they give up.
Yes.
But it be like say now waiting our politicians, the bad ones among them, they want. Make it frustrate us, make we run, leave the country for them. Make them continue with the thing when they do. I would like to encourage Nigerians.
Yes.
Give them confidence. Say no matter how the thing take bad reach, if all of us there, we'll go do and well. But before you talk, Ikechukwu, they call us from Lagos. Oga Ikechukwu, welcome to Asi the Heart.
Hey, my Oga, good evening, sir.
I greet you, Oga Ikechukwu.
Yeah, I just watched this program for the first time, though.
Yeah.
And I really like the talk, yeah. This thing is impressive. I know they took the house.
Oh, thank God for public holiday.
Out this evening. I just watched the program. The program interests me.
Thank you.
Yeah, and kudos to the guest.
Thank you.
Sorry, the name skipped my mind.
Barista Olugbani.
Okay. So, the issue we want quickly bring in now, this current expenditure and the
capital expenditure.
Yes, because the recurrent expenditure can't be like, say, the percentage too high for the current expenditure.
Mm.
Because the recurrent expenditure, now you say the thing, they enter some kind people, them
pockets.
Say, yes, now to restructure the drugs, the allowance, and every other thing for Aso Rock. Then the recurrent expenditure, now to build roads,
capital, schools,
hospitals, and all that, yeah? If that is what I heard correctly.
Mm.
Okay. Now, the issue now, I say, we know to really get issue. We say current expenditure, the recurrent expenditure, rather, the N60% or more than the current expenditure. Then let the allocation where they go to the current expenditure, as our Oga for the house talk, make sure, say, we get body where they look into all this allocation money, say the reason, do the right thing. You get now which body or which agency wants stand out to take fight for all those things, you know, because everybody is here, nobody wants die. We all know the truth for this country. If we just live, say, with the talk too much, they say plenty talk, not the full basket. You understand?
Very, very
so
true.
So, if you get agency, I'm not a politician though. But I just, you know, they impressed.
When go they check?
Things about Nigeria don't tire me.
Okay.
Now talk.
Okay, we appreciate this idea. When you don't carry gifts, say, make we get people when they chook eye inside, make we see. But make I not like give you. For Nigeria, we get committee. When they look the work of committee, when we come give another committee, the work when that committee don't do. Like, Oga Olugbani, don't talk. As Nigerians, now we suppose they put our eye. You, as you do like that now, who be the person when they represent you for the Lagos State House of Assembly? Who be the person when they represent you for the Federal House of Representatives? Who be the person when they represent you for your senatorial zone? You know all these people. If we know, imagine election what we do. See number of people we register, 84 million. See number of people we collect PVC, 79 million. See number of people we come out to come vote for inside election. So if you ask yourself, say, okay, if these people, this number of people, they come, we're really serious about this country, we need to be involved. Maybe we lock our telephone line now because we don't reach the place where we say, now home run, now we did. Just give us your final word. And remember, sir, I've been telling you, make you encourage Nigerians so that we don't go tire.
Well, for Nigerians, I want to encourage them, say, make them no tire. Why this life, this hope? All the countries will be like, say, that they develop today. This kind of thing, they don't pass through them. And they only say they don't pass through them earlier than we. But Nigeria, they pass through it all, and democracy is just about 20 years. So the hope, now say, before it reach 30 years, things go down stabilize, bad people go down come out, people won't repair Nigeria, go down dead here, and as things they go on, the one way no good because they drop up, the one way good because they retain them for the way we they run this country. On that issue of where, how we going to take put eye for the kind of proposal, whether they put for budget. Even the during Obasanjo time, Dr. Obi Ezekwesili, he get the head one agency or department that they call due process Kiniko, where if any contract won't come out for federal government, then go scrutinize how much be the money when they won't take by that thing. Mm. How much be the money when they go actually spend? What will be the profit margin for the contractor? Similarly, there's nothing wrong if we have an appropriation committee and the auditor general of the federal government, the state government, local government doing their job properly. Mm. Because they are the ones who are supposed to look at the budget proposals. What is the realistic price of this costing or this estimate? Mm-hmm. What is the one that is written in the budget? Mm. What is the profit margin or loss? Or what value does it add to the area where they're going to do the work? Mm-hmm. Is the costing appropriate? Is it inflated? Or is it inadequate? So if everybody was doing their work properly, and I always say, by doing the right thing, Nigeria can never go wrong. Mm. If all of us know the right thing to do, and we continue to do it, whether you are a private citizen, you are a government official, a public servant, a politician, or the people who are holding the highest offices in the land, if we do the right thing, Nigeria will be okay. Mm.
So by doing the right thing, Nigeria will be never go wrong.
Yes.
Nigeria will be okay.
Yes.
From today, everybody, you put your hand for your chest, say, today, I will begin to do, if I say this chest, touch your head, because now says now we need. From today, I will begin to do the right thing, and Nigeria will move forward. Barrister, I appreciate say you carry Waka come inside studio.
Thank you,
and
sir.
I like the way when we say, you don't open our eyes for all the talk, and when consign our great Obodo, Nigeria. Our people went there for us with the talk, say Nigeria and our country, it no go spoil. Make we join our hand together to move this our country, go the permanent site. Until we come back again tomorrow with plenty topic where they come on smoke. Una bye bye. Thank you very much, sir. To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.